What is financial statement analysis? What is financial analysis? Okay, I got a picture of a baseball player here, okay? Did anybody play baseball in high school? Okay. Okay, you can come off of that. Baseball has a ton of statistics that they keep track of. Is that correct? ERA, batting average, slugging percentage. What are some others? On-base percentage.
Whip.
What's whip?
Walks plus hits per inning.
Walks plus, I've never heard that one. Walks plus hits per inning. But they have all of these ratios. Now, you played in high school, you two? Did you have somebody who kept track of this stuff for the team?
I'm sure, yeah.
Yeah, I'm sure you did too. Coaches always keep track of this stuff. Why would a coach want to have that information? Because it's going to help them make better decisions, right? Okay, Michael, for example, they could keep statistics for you and they could compare it to how you were doing last year or how you were doing the early part of the season, right? Or what they could do is, let's say you played first base. They could compare it to the statistics gathered for other first basemen, right? Okay. Or they could compare it to maybe statistics for whatever league your team was in, right? Or there's also certain rules of thumb that are used in analysis. For example, what's the rule of thumb about your batting average? If your batting average is what or higher, is it considered pretty good?
Your playing weight.
Your playing weight? I've never heard that. I've always heard just 300.
Yeah.
If you're batting 300 or better, that's generally considered pretty good. But it's just a rule of thumb, right? Okay. So, but the same reason and thinking process for keeping these different created ratios and statistics for baseball players also applies to the financial analysis that we do for businesses. Going to the slides, it helps us transform data into tools that will help us to analyze the situation more efficiently and more effectively. It reduces the uncertainty, right? If I go, well, I think Michael's not batting as well as this year as he did last year. Well, why don't you get the statistics? Let's gather his batting average, right? And let's compare it to what he did last year, okay? So it's the same sort of thought process, okay? Now, and ultimately, as I said, it helps users make better decisions, okay? Now, just like those comparisons were made with you, Michael, we have these same sort of comparisons with businesses. We have to be able to interpret these statistics, and we have to have standards of comparison, right? It's not enough just to have a number, right? Okay? It's like when I go to the doctor and they do like a cholesterol test and they go, your cholesterol is 39. And I'm like, well, okay, is that good or bad? I don't know, right? Okay? So you have to have standards of comparison. Well, Michael, we said that we could compare you to previous years, right? That is kind of analogous to intra-company comparison, okay? Comparisons within the company in past periods. Or competitors. Like I said, I might compare you to other first basemen, right? That's analogous to this one right here, this standard of comparison. Now, obviously, it has to be a meaningful comparison. In baseball, you wouldn't want to evaluate a pitcher's batting average compared to that of a designated hitter, would you? Because those are two different positions, right? Well, I wouldn't want to take the ratios of a steel manufacturing company and compare them with the ratios of a flower retail shop, right? Does that make sense? No, it doesn't make any sense. So that leads us to this third area of comparison, which is industry. Sometimes different industries will put out these monthly magazines or monthly periodicals or quarterly that gather anonymous statistics from the industry so that you can compare how your specific company is doing in that industry. Does that make sense? And then, of course, as there are rules of thumb or more general guidelines in baseball, like I said, a batting average of 3.0 or if you bat 300 or more, that's considered good. There's these rules of thumb or guidelines in businesses as well. For example, a rule of thumb is that your current ratio, you want it to be at least 2.0. I've heard that. Okay. So, but do you see how these kind of relate? It's a lot like sports statistics. Okay. It's a lot like sports statistics.